dripping off of him and a ring on every finger of his hand. He wore a big old turban wrapped around his head, a scimitar by his side. And every evening about midnight, he'd jump on his camel named Clyde and ride silently through the night to the Sultan's tent, where he would secretly meet up with Fatima of the Seven Veils. She was the swinginest number one dancer in the Sultan's whole harem. It was like him and her, they had a little item going, you see, behind the old booger's back. And you could hear him talking to his camel as he rode out across the dunes, past the oil wells. His voice would cut through the still night desert air, and he'd say, Arabic for, whoa, baby. And Clyde would say, well, he brought his camel to a screaming halt. The rear of a team was 10. Jumped off Clyde, sank around the corner, and into the tent he went. Saw Fatima laying on a zebra skin rug, with rings on her fingers, bells on her toes, and a bone in her nose. There she was, friends and neighbors, laying there in all her radiant beauty. She was eating on a raisin and a grape and a apricot and a pomegranate, a bowl of chitlins, two bananas, three Hershey bars, four burritos, a sipping on a frozen margarita, listening to a transistor radio, watching the Grand Ole Opry, reading Rolling Stone magazine, and singing Rocky Mountain High. And Ahab walked up to her and he say, Arabic for her. Let's boogie again like we did last summer, baby. And she say, oh, Ahab. Ahab. Crazy, baby. And that's the story about Ahab. Ahab. She got